Well, good Monday morning. It is so good to see you. We are beginning a brand new daily Devo series called Unity Now. So it's Unity Now. The whole George Floyd thing has all of us grieving. I know I have been weeping over this situation, and I believe that Jesus established the church, and one major purpose for that is to bring peace and unity to the world. So believers, we need to come alive with the Spirit of God, because the Holy Spirit always brings peace and unity. In fact, Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers." I plan on talking a lot about that. A lot of people have been posting, and I've been thinking about what the Apostle John said in 1 John chapter 4, verse 20. He says this: "Whoever claims to love God, yet hates his brother or sister, is a liar. Whoever does not love his brother or sister, whom they've seen, cannot love God, whom they've not seen." That's a powerful word. That's a really powerful word. And so today I want to talk about the gospel itself unites. You see, the gospel unites. And at Pentecost, God knew that people from 15 nations from the known world would be gathered in one place. And so when he released the Holy Spirit, that gospel that they were able to preach, they were tongues of fire that came upon them. The Holy Spirit did one main thing. He fulfilled what Jesus said would happen. Jesus said, "Wait in Jerusalem, you will receive power to be my witnesses." That's what Pentecost is all about. When tongues of fire came on each of them, the 120 believers began to speak and preach the gospel supernaturally in the known languages of the 15 nations that were gathered. That's how much God loves the world. In fact, centuries earlier, there was the dispersion of all the Jews throughout the world. The 15 nations that came together in Jerusalem for the Feast of Pentecost was the Jews who had been scattered, or converts to Judaism, Gentiles that converted. So what is God up to? God so loved the world that he gave his only son, and Pentecost was about spreading the message so that the Prince of Peace could be in the hearts of the people. You know, Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God." So what God was doing is by bringing people from all over the world to faith in Christ, he was spreading out peacemakers everywhere because of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so when we are peacemakers, it means that we author peace, that we create peace, that we construct it, we make it, that wherever we go as Christians, we become a force for creating peace. And so when you see this whole crisis with the police brutality there in Minneapolis, I believe it was from racism. But obviously, we're not going to stereotype all police, because I have relatives that are police, and they're good people. They want to go out and love people and serve people. I love our Plymouth police force here. I'm friends with the chief of police. I pray for them regularly. They are not racist, as far as I know, and certainly I know the chief isn't, and I know many police. They're not racist. They love people. So we can't stereotype police as much as we can't stereotype different ethnicities. This is not of God. This is really demonic. And so what do? We need to be people, believers, who will say, "Spirit of God, fill me," just like you did at Pentecost. "Fill me with your love, fill me with your kindness, fill me with your wisdom, and make me a peacemaker. Help me, Lord, to go beyond my own friends that I feel comfortable with. Help me go and establish peace. Help me, God, to have conversations with people who are of a different color, especially with our African American brothers and sisters, the people around us. It is so Christ-like for us to go sit down, have conversations, listen with open hearts, show God's love. This is exactly what God was up to. You know, in Acts chapter 2, here's some of the nations that were represented. Modern-day Iran, modern-day Iraq and Kuwait, Syria, Turkey, Asia, Libya, the island of Crete, Saudi Arabia, the Arabian Peninsula, Europe, Italy, Rome, all throughout the world. What was God doing? He loved the world. He was uniting us. He was uniting people through belief in Christ and really bringing about a powerful change in the world. Without Jesus, our whole world would look completely different. So, Acts chapter 1, verse 8, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. You will be my witnesses. Where? Jerusalem, where the Holy Spirit was poured out. And then from there, they were to go to Judea and then Samaria. Now we're breaking outside of the Jewish comfort zone, and they're going into Samaria and then the uttermost parts of the earth. You see, God was sending peacemakers. Peacemakers are authors of a cause. Peacemakers go into different ethnoses. Jesus said in Matthew 28:19, go make disciples of all nations, all ethnos. Ethnos means different ethnicities. Go make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Do you see this? So peacemakers are very intentional. In fact, God sent Philip. Philip now was a deacon. And so he sends him from waiting on tables, helping the widows, when they were scattered because of the martyrdom of Stephen. Philip went to Samaria, where they were half-breed, half-Jewish, half-pagan Gentile. Normally, the Jewish people wouldn't even go near Samaria. They were at odds with Samaria. They had a historical hostility with them. But no, God sends him right there to Samaria, and Philip, a Jewish man, with these Gentiles, a revival breaks out because he intentionally goes. He's a peacemaker. He's bringing the gospel of Christ, and the city is completely changed. And then God says, now leave the city, go down a dusty road, and I'll show you what to do. So the Holy Spirit guides him through an angel, and then he sees a man on a chariot from Ethiopia. Now God's about to bring Philip the evangelism to one man, and he happens to be a man that works for the Queen of Candace of Ethiopia. And now he goes back because he encountered Christ, and Philip helps him and interpret Isaiah 53, which is a messianic scripture about Jesus. And then he baptizes the Ethiopian eunuch, and then God sends him back to Ethiopia because God so loves the Ethiopians. And he was going to send an evangelist there to spread the gospel, a government official. How powerful is that? You see, peacemakers, we go preaching Christ and sharing Christ with bringing the kindness and the love of Jesus in the way that we act and present ourselves, and also with the actual words of the gospel. Peacemakers. So Philip, he had a reputation of already he was spirit-filled, he was wise, he was qualified, he was willing to serve widows. He was willing to serve the marginalized. He was faithful to bring the gospel, as Jesus said, to the ethnos, ethnicities. He was willing to go. He preached Christ in Samaria with signs following. The Holy Spirit was upon him. I believe that there's something very significant about this 2020 Pentecost. I believe that it's launching a greater movement of the Spirit of God in God's people. So, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. I want to close with a story. A man named Shorty Banks, an African American, he was in the Korean War with my dad, like a battle buddy. I believe that he also was a Christian. My dad formed a bond, a friendship with Shorty Banks, this African American. Well, one day when my dad and Shorty and a group of other guys were kind of hanging around the barracks, my dad wrestled three of them and he pinned all three. And this one big guy says, "You won't be able to pin me." And my dad said, "I'll pin you in 3 minutes." My father pinned him to the ground because he was a good wrestler in 3 minutes. Well, then that night, that same guy that my dad pinned to the ground woke up in the middle of the night and he was going over to stab my father. I guess he wasn't happy about the pinning. Well, Shorty Banks was awake and he saw this and he went and stopped this man from killing or wounding my dad. My dad treasured Shorty Banks because he stepped outside of his ethnicity to love on my white father. And they had a friendship, a bond that they initiated because they were both peacemakers. I want to tell you something. Let's find a way to be peacemakers today. Peacemakers are barrier breakers. We go beyond what's comfortable and we say, "I'm going to initiate. I'm going to initiate a relationship with somebody that I normally never would even think of doing." I hope you'll do that today. God bless you. Let's pray for our country. We need healing.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed.
Come on, rejoice.
My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love. Amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns, unending love, amazing grace. Shall soon dissolve like snow, the sun forbear to shine. But God, who called me here below, will be forever mine, will be forever mine. You are forever mine.
Isn't it so good to sing about his amazing grace? Have an awesome rest of your day. We love you so much.